Hey, Cooking Hot Roofer here. So I haven't done anything in a while, so I've decided to kind of come up with something. Got my steak here. It's frozen. It's literally frozen. I was gonna do it one way, but decided to do it another way. And I've got my dough here. It's frozen as well. Yeah. So I was gonna make it like a regular steak, how I make put the banana and everything else. Then I decided, you know what, I'm gonna do something different. So I'm gonna thaw out my steak in hot water. I'm gonna put my dough in hot water for a little while just to help thaw it out. And then when I come back, I'll show you what I'm gonna do. So I go through 100 things before I decide to make up my mind on what I'm gonna make. So now I've changed my mind again. Even though I am using the dough and I'm gonna use the roast, but we're gonna do it differently today. We're gonna take this steamer. You don't got one? Sorry, I don't know what to tell you. But we're gonna make steamed, barbecued deer buns today. So, with that said, I'm gonna show you all the flavors that I've got. I take garlic, just real quick note. I take garlic and I freeze it. And then I just cut it up to where and how I want to. I like garlic a lot. So, it's not as strong now, but it's still, you can still taste the flavor. And I'm gonna use barbecue sauce, and I might even add some hot sauce that I got from Hungry Volcano. That's the name of it. Out here in Alberta here. Yes, Hungry Volcano. So I got some flavors from them, and I'll probably add that to it. So I'm sorry for bouncing around. So yeah, I'm just waiting for the meat to thaw out. I'm waiting for the dough to finish up here. It's almost done. I still feel a little bit in there. It's kind of, you know, it's not frozen much anymore, but it's still cold in the center. I can still feel that. So I'm just gonna let this warm up. And my deer is just about thawed out. So until then, I'll come back. So I got my roast here. It is game meat, so I did have to wash it, and I'm just gonna cut it up into pieces. And then I'm actually gonna fry it up. So I'm not gonna be doing, you know, cut the steak with a spoon kind of thing today. I'm gonna make steamed buns today. So what I wanna do is just cut this up. Just cutting it up big for now, and then we'll cut it up smaller. Just like that. So we can either leave it like this, in pieces about just shy of 3 inches. Yeah, just shy. My middle finger is 3 inches. And so it's about 3 inches. Or we can cut it up into smaller pieces. Yeah, and we'll cut it up into half that. So it'll almost be cubes. But I'm gonna get this done, and then when I come back, I'll show you. So I'm just adding a little bit of oil. I did clean out the oil earlier. Made brand new oil. These are my beef chunks, deer chunks, just little pieces. I'm just gonna mix this around a little bit because there's no fat in this meat, so it's really lean. So, with that said, I'm gonna take these, have them over there, turn them on. Put the oil back in here. I don't use a deep fryer, as you can see. I just use a regular pot, but I have two of them. And my favorite spoon, it's hard as a rock, but it works well. Dollar store. So when I come back, I'll show you what else I do. The other thing I wanted to mention, it's obvious with all steak, like red meats, but when you're doing, move this out of the way. When you're doing deer in a cast iron pan like this, and you want it fully cooked, like 100%, you want the blood and everything, you know how rare, medium rare, still get a little bit of blood, right? What you want is all of it gone, because you're gonna be sticking these in this in bread, right? The best thing you can do is start cooking it, like once when that little bit of juice that you get from the steak or from the deer or whatever it is, once when that's gone, turn off your heat completely. Just turn it right off. And then just let the heat from the burner, the element, like if you're using a glass top like I am, just let it cook the rest of the way. Now with the water, what I've done is, okay, enough. I've gotten my water here, added some chicken bouillon to it, just as the flavor. And I'm just gonna leave that like that. I'm gonna do my dough, and I'll show you what I'm gonna do with that. And I didn't add any spice to the meat. It's gonna be just bare meat. I'm gonna add the spice once when I start making it. So until then, I'll come back and I'll show you what I do. So I got my dough. I've already laid down some flour. Just get it all floured up here, right? And if you want, cut it in half. Just put it in the bowl that I placed over there. You want to roll it out. And you kind of hope that you find a patch that isn't got flour or that doesn't have flour on it. So then it'll stick a little bit, and then you can not have it follow you everywhere like it is. That's the frustrating part. Did I turn on my water? Yep. No, I didn't. Okay, so my water's on. And you're obviously gonna wanna cut this dough up a little bit more. If you want to find something to make little circles, you can. I'll give you a really good idea in a minute here, because I'm going to put you on pause in a bit. When I can get this finished rolling up, I'm sure you don't want to watch me do this. I'm just rolling the dough. So, and when I come back, I'll show you what else I do. I'm just using this little glass here, giving me a little curve here. So I'm gonna take that, out. So now we got these little. And they're the perfect size. So, and when I come back, I'll actually turn off the music and then I'll show you what else I do. Another thing I should let you know is these do shrink a little bit. So you just want to, just the weight of the rolling pin. This is a marble pin, so this one's got a little bit of weight to it, which works well. And it'll flatten it right out. So you take your spoon, take a couple pieces of meat, throw that in there, piece of garlic, throw that in there. Oh, hold on, I'll be right back. Okay, so the other thing you want to do, if you feel like it, take a cherry tomato and just cut it in half. Add half a tomato. Save the other half for another one. Grab your barbecue sauce. Throw it on. What you want to do is just pinch it all together. If it stretches a little bit, that's okay. If it doesn't want to stick together, make it stick. Add water, add some butter if you wanted to. It's up to you. So yeah, it looks little, and it is little, but by the time it rises and it's done, it'll be awesome. So I'll do all of this, and when I come back, I'll show you. So I'm just showing you this. All I did was add like two or three pieces of meat into the dough. Here we go. A piece of tomato, like I just cut the cherry tomatoes in half, right? Cherry tomatoes, cut them in half, and put a half a piece in there. That garlic that I used, same thing. So all I'm gonna do is just kind of gently pull this thing up so it doesn't wreck at all. Just take it and pinch it together. Now, take in consideration, this is the first time I've ever made this. This is all new to me. And so, and yeah, if you got a better idea, please let me know. But this is how I'm doing it. And so, this is how I do it. Sometimes you get the barbecue sauce, it's just a little bit too much. But there you go. It's all together. No little holes in it or anything like that. And I'm gonna stick these in the steamer and I'll show you how I do that. So I got both of them being filled right now. That's the last four that I have. I've already done a couple. Right there. They're actually really good too. Thing. Barbecue sauce everywhere on them. They're a little bit gooey, but if you wanted to add a little bit of cheese or something to it, you could. So there you go. I showed you how to do that, and you can see that they're cooking. You see what they look like. And so it's charging again. So I'm gonna clean up here, and then that'll be it. And that's another cooking show from Cookin' Hot Roofer.